Hi, good evening to all. Today we are going to look at the how to calculate the Carl Pearson's coefficient of skewnesses. It is it comes in business statistic book. We have some data through which we have to calculate the coefficient of skewnesses under Carl Pearson's method. Wages are given, the number of items are also given. First, we need to prepare the table for this. Through tabular presentation, we need to apply the formula. Then we need to find out the coefficient. The title would be calculation of a Carl Pearson's coefficient of skewnesses. Skewnesses is nothing. It's a measure of the symmetry of a distribution. It depends on mean, median, and mode. The highest point of a distribution is its mode. So the first column is wage. We can call it as x column. Then item column, we can name it as frequency. Then t of x, we need to assume the sender value of x column as 0, because it has a total 7, right? The number of the items is 7, so we need to distribute 3 plus 3, and then the middle one is 0, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 are upper values, 1, 2, 3, the below values. The summation of tx is equal to 0. Then we need to find out the f of tx. Just multiply the frequency and tx, we can get f of tx. And then we need to add them to find out the summation of f of tx. It is equal to 32. Then tx squared, just square the tx and add them, we can find the summation of tx squared as well as f of tx squared. F of tx squared we need to multiply tx and f of tx, we can get f of tx squared. Or we need to we have f of tx, right? Just square it, we can get f of tx. By both way, we can find out the f of the summation of the f of tx squared as 404. Summation of frequency also we have to find out, as we have already found it as 200. Once we have done the tabulation, moving forward to the apply of formulas. First, we need to write the formula of the Carl Pearson's coefficient of skewnesses. The SK denotes as skewnesses of Carl Pearson's. Formula is mean minus mode divided by standard deviation. It's called sigma also. Mean usually calls it x bar mod we can call it as na z. So mean formula a plus sigma f of tx na by the sigma frequency. Here a is na the assumed value. That is a 25, right? We have assumed the value as now 25 as a 0. Then in the a sigma f of tx is equal to 32. Summation of a frequency na is equal to 200. We need to apply the value. We can get the mean as a 25.16. Then moving forward to the mode. Mode is the highest frequency. Which frequency is the highest? We have to find out that one. In and this na table na 70 is the highest value. So the horizontal of the horizontal value of the 70 is 25. That is the model. We have now looked at the highest value of a frequency through which we have to find out the mode. Then standard deviation, its formula square root of the summation of f of tx squared divided by the summation of the frequency minus summation of the f of tx upon summation of a frequency whole squared. We have already now calculated these values. So we will directly apply them in this formula. Finally, the we can get the value as the square root 2. If we now take the square of 2, we can get 1.41. It is our standard deviation. So the final formula is skewnesses of the coefficient to them is equal to mean minus mode upon standard deviation. Mean is a 25.16, mode is a 25, standard deviation is 1.41. If we apply this value, we can get the answer as 0.113. It's our final answer. The answer would be now less than 1 always. The answer now would be always less than 1. Thank you. We will see you again with another important topic. Until then, stay tuned, stay blessed, stay enlightened forever. Thank you so much. Bye.